Hi, I'm Sean Hessinger, and this is Small Biz in 15, the show where we bring you small business success in 15 minutes or less. Please like and subscribe if you enjoyed the show. And please listen to the end for our small biz tip in 15 seconds or less. Though gas prices may finally be heading down after record highs earlier this year, it's time for small businesses to think about how to deal with higher prices at the pump long term. Small Business Operations Manager Catherine Boudreau has some suggestions you may not have even considered. So Catherine, to start out, what are some of the basic ways higher gas prices can impact small businesses?
Well, I think really in a myriad of different ways, because, you know, gas prices affect our everyday living costs. So, you know, people are spending more at the pump, they're less likely to buy other things, food prices are going up, you know, they're less likely to go to your brick and mortar store and buy that t-shirt, or, you know, they're cutting costs. Also, you know, you might need to increase the salary of your employees, because as their cost of living goes up, you know, you're going to have to compensate for that too, which that can be a big burden on small businesses. Additionally, you're gonna probably have to like raise your prices to offset the increase in the cost of producing your products. Especially like if your products are plastic based or any type of petroleum based product, you're going to see big increases in those. And also, it makes it harder to find good job candidates too, because you might have an issue where, you know, a 40 minute commute for someone just isn't doable at the end of the day. You know, they're not going to want to drive and spend all that money and have all that money taken out of their paycheck every week just to get to work. So I think there's a lot of different things that will affect small businesses if the prices of gases continue to increase. And I think a lot of small businesses have already been feeling these effects.
What are some simple ways you can start to combat this as a small business? Because as we said before the show started, gas prices are on their way down now. But I mean, realistically, they're not as low as they were a year ago. And who knows, mm-hmm. but that we might see more spikes. It's a reality. People are probably wise to plan for.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, I think simple things that you can do are just creating a more flexible work environment. Say, for example, I mean, instead of like a 9-to-5, you allow your employee to work like 7-to-3 to avoid rush hour and things like that, so they're not sitting in traffic. Or also doing a hybrid type of work environment where they're not having to come in every day to the office, so they're saving money in that way. You can, you know, reduce your service area. If you're delivering things, you know, don't deliver as far. You can also batch deliveries. And I think one really important thing for companies that do a lot of deliveries or do a lot of, you know, they drive out to provide services is really streamlining your routing and your dispatching and like making sure it makes sense for, you know, them to go to point A to point B to point C and not having, you know, the people that you're sending out drive in routes that don't make sense.
I guess even e-commerce people are affected by
definitely
in shipping.
Yeah, I mean, e-commerce businesses definitely feel it. You know, I work for a number of kind of e-commerce businesses and websites, and you know, our third-party delivery companies, service providers, you know, they raise their prices, which in turn forces us to charge more for shipping, increase prices on the products that we're selling as well. So you can also shop around for different service providers, you know, compare prices. It's a good opportunity, I think, to look at all of the different parts of your business to see where you can cut costs, you know, maybe there's a better competitor out there that's offering a better price for the services that you need to outsource, like delivering.
What are some really big questions that maybe you need to look at if you're going back to your business plan to try and deal with rising gas prices?
One of my things that I like to do with the different kind of brands that we manage is we track all of like the key performance indicators. And I think it's important to track them all the time. And I think you can connect the dots if you're constantly tracking them and see what's being affected by higher gas prices, you know, and you can analyze your business plan and say, okay, you know what, you know, delivering to this wide of an area isn't really, it's not cost effective for us. So we're going to, you know, decrease our delivery area, or having this many stores isn't cost effective. So we're going to reduce the amount of stores that we have. Or, you know, having our customer service team come in isn't really cost effective. We're going to put them in a work from home program. I think so it allows you to kind of analyze where you can cut costs, what you can fix in your business plan so that you can continue to, you know, survive during these kind of turbulent times that we're in.
Higher gas prices may be a problem for some small businesses, but an opportunity for others. Evan Singer, CEO of AI-powered financial platform SmartBiz, has some suggestions for how small businesses can meet that challenge. So Evan, let's talk about the rise of electric and how that can impact small businesses and how they can pivot in regards to that.
Yeah, we're seeing that in our customers today. I mean, we just talked about small businesses pivoting and figuring things out, and we're certainly seeing that with the clients that we work with. So for example, we have been helping service stations put in an electric module for electric charging. And as more and more consumers buy electric cars, service stations need some place for that person to charge. And it's interesting because often if somebody's charging for 15, 20 minutes, they'll go inside and they'll buy additional food or other services. So it ends up being a very profitable option for a service center, but they're expensive, the modules. And so we're actually, we will often do equipment financing with a long term for someone to put that in, and they can finance the unit and drive up the amount of money that they make. It's a very interesting pivot that we're seeing happen out in the market.
So Evan, what are some other small businesses that might benefit from the rise of electricity?
Sean, beyond just service stations, I mean, we're seeing small businesses. We serve a lot of electricians and plumbers and contractors, and we will see those folks get additional capital to either bring on headcount or put in, you know, for their employees to put in units into people's houses for actually a large battery that somebody might put into their garage. They'll hire a contractor, an electrician, to put that unit in. And so that electrician may need to hire a couple people, and they'll use funds from an SBA or a bank loan that we've helped them get in order to get the right personnel to do that job.
Let's talk a little bit about some steps that we can talk about in terms of financing options, because maybe that's something that small businesses don't think about a lot when they're dealing with costs. What kind of financing options can help businesses deal with, I guess, not only rising gas prices, but rising prices in general?
Look, there's a myriad of financing options for small businesses out in the market today. It certainly can be confusing. What we do at SmartBiz is really help businesses get the right financing at the right time. It's often looking at not just interest rates, but also the term of loans. We're finding, especially in these times, that getting a low monthly payment can really help. And so we specialize in helping businesses get bank loans, and in particular SBA loans, with some of the longest terms out there. But finding loans with a low monthly payment can give businesses maximum flexibility. And in these, I'd say, more turbulent times, getting that maximum flexibility can really help.
What are some ways that small businesses are affected by gas prices beyond just what they're paying at the pump? And then how can they work to control factors that go beyond just, you know, how much gas they're actually using?
Yeah, look, gas prices increases affects everything, especially from a supply chain standpoint. So you're right. It's not just about driving to the pump and going to work. It's affecting the entire supply chain, which drives up prices. It also affects if that particular small business has clients and customers that come to their location, it affects how much money is in those people's pocket. And so as far as what folks can do to kind of help, I'd say, make that better. We talked about a few around getting some incremental financing that can help withstand the pressure. So from a working capital standpoint, it might mean that folks have to be more diligent on their inventory purchases. So if, for example, they can get a good deal on inventory at a lower price, I'd say it's not a bad idea to get some additional capital to actually stock up on inventory if they can find a low price. Obviously, they've got to sit on that inventory longer, and they'll need the working capital to be able to do that. But that's the type of thing that folks have to think about.
And now it's time for our small biz tip in 15 seconds or less. Look at high gas prices as an opportunity to cut costs and to provide new services for your customers. Entrepreneurship is about solving problems, and high gas prices are just another example. Thanks again to our small business experts, and please like and subscribe if you enjoyed the show. And please leave a comment and let us know what topics you'd like to see covered in future programs. For more small business news and tips, join us at smallbiztrends.com.